guys, what's up and welcome back to my channel. Today's video, I'm going to be giving you an updated skincare routine. I know I've done one of this like last year, but this year I'm just going to update it because there's a lot of things that has changed over the year's time. So without any further rambling, let's just get into the video. So like I said, even in my previous video, drink lots of water. Water, water, water. Drink it. Please. That solves a lot of problems for your skin. Secondly, wash your face at least 3 times a day. And for face wash, now, like, I would still go for the Himalaya neem face wash. But right now, I'm just using this Fresh Start Oil Clear Face Wash Lemon. So this is the one that I'm currently using. But once this gets over, it's literally right here. So once this gets over, I'm just going to purchase the neem face wash because that's still my favorite. The next face wash that I'm gonna use is by Korres, and it is the Greek Yogurt Foaming Cream Cleanser. Now this is very mild for the skin, and that is why I like using this as my second cleanser. So what I do is I use this twice a day and this once a day. So yeah, these are basically the two cleansers that I'm currently using. I might change it up with my Himalaya again. But this one, I'm so far liking it, so yeah, go for this. I don't know what the price is for all these products. I could probably leave them all in the description bar down below, so have a look over there. So once that is done, in the morning, I start off with this. So this is the, I think, Lord and something. I don't know what company this is, to be honest. I threw the packaging like long back, but this is a vitamin C smooth and brightening like serum kind of thing. And this really like, this acts like a primer as well, and that's one thing I really like about this. So it's very smooth. It literally disappears in 2 seconds. It's gone. So I really like that. It does have a little bit of a weird smell, but it's not something that lingers around. It goes away immediately, so that's a good thing about this. So I would definitely recommend using some kind of serum because that really helps hydrate and moisturize your skin like from within, because it sucks up everything from your skin. Like, it's literally being sucked into your skin, which is perfect and which is what you want for your skin. So once I'm done with that, I use the Korres Wild Rose Brightening Vitamin C Brightening 24-Hour Moisturizer. Now this is how it looks. When you open it, it's just a really like gel type of a cream. I don't know if y'all can even see it. But again, this is so lightweight. It literally vanishes in 2 seconds, and your skin feels so soft, so hydrated. Again, I don't know how much the price is. I think it's a little bit more on the expensive side, but it's really good. It has really helped my skin a lot. But the best part about this, I will mention towards the end of like this company course of what I use. So yeah, that's good. So this is something I would use like on a daily basis. And if I am gonna go out or like have, if my skin is gonna have some exposure to the sun, then I use this cream, which is La Roche-Posay Toleriane Double Repair Face Moisturizer, and it does have SPF 30. I do have the Kaya sunscreen as well, which is my mom's, but I steal it, so you know, you could use that. But the best sunscreen so far for like dark skin is definitely the Body Shop, you know, the white tube one which I showed earlier. No, I don't have that right now with me, but that's a really good one, so I should probably purchase that again. But this is a really good cream as well. It is a moisturizer which has SPF, so I wouldn't recommend using this in the night or whatever. It is a little more on the thicker side. It is white, as you can see. It's just cream. It's something, again, just gets soaked into your skin, feeling really soft. But one thing about this cream is that I find that on my face, it looks a little bit on the oilier side, which is not my look for when I want to put makeup on and things like that. But if you don't want to put any makeup on and just go out with like cream that has sunscreen, definitely this one. Again, more expensive side, but like I said in my previous video, I like to splurge a little bit more when it comes to my skincare and a little bit less when it comes to my makeup. So yeah. Okay, so another thing I want to talk about in this video is from Halo Beauty. Now these pills are amazing. I think I have finished like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 bottles. I'm on my 7th one and I have a backup, which is the 8th one. Now these are genuinely amazing. Like, I'm a huge fan of Tati for sure. Tati's a huge makeup artist, not artist, she's a makeup YouTuber or whatever on YouTube, but it's basically her brand, Halo Beauty, and I kid you not, it is amazing. So I have the Halo Beauty Kiwi Seed Booster, which is for the skin. Okay, by the way, this is basically pills. They're kind of like supplements, you can say, or like vitamin boosters kind of thing. Yeah, that's what these are. So I have the Kiwi Seed Booster, which is for skin, and then I have the Hair Skin Nails Booster, which is pink in color. So if I had to pick one, I would definitely pick the Hair Skin and Nails, because they really do work, like, not gonna lie, it is amazing. It is very expensive, I'm gonna say that, but it's definitely an investment. It's definitely worth your money, and I can 100% say that it's amazing. I've tried probably the skin one only twice, but I've tried a lot more. Like, all the rest of the 6 that I've tried is probably like the Hair Skin and Nails, and I would highly recommend researching into it and getting yourself one if you guys really do want one. So yeah. Next up, like, after I use the Korres face wash, I always like use this oil. So basically I got this as a set, and that is why suddenly I'm using all these brand products. But this is a Wild Rose Vitamin C Active Brightening Oil, and this is how it looks. And I don't know if y'all can tell, like, inside there is a little bit of these dried rose petals, I think. It does come like in a dropper form, which is good. I use like the tiniest bit because I don't like oils on my face personally. So I try to like use it because I don't want to waste it. But at the same time, I definitely do see that there is a lot of difference in my skin once I've started using this. So that's really good. Now in the night, again, I would use this. And then what I do is, under my eyes, I've been using this thing called the E.L.F. Beauty Shield. Now, like, under eye creams were things that I've never been like used or like bought or anything, but for some reason I got this. I think it was on sale or something, so I was like, you know what, it's like $3 or something, so I was just gonna buy it. And I did get it, and oh my god, this really like plumps up your under eye. The coolest thing about this is basically it has like 3 metal tips right at the edge over there, and then when you press it like that, I don't know if y'all can see, but there is, oh my god, okay, y'all can see, so there is a little bit of cream coming. And then what you do is basically with those metal tips, you kind of like massage under your eye, and it is the best feeling. Like, it's so good. Now I don't completely like massage it in to my under eye, but like I just leave like a little bit, maybe like that, so you can see a little bit white there, and I let it dry basically. So while that is drying, what I do is, again, I go back and I use the Korres Wild Rose Vitamin C Brightening Sleeping Facial. Now this is, again, the same packaging as the moisturizer, and I take this literally like the tiniest bit for now. I usually use a lot more, and basically it's like a overnight like face mask kind of thing, and I just like wipe it all over my face and go to sleep with it, and the next day I do the same damn thing again. So yeah. I also have this thing, which is the Dr. Pawpaw Original Balm Multi-Purpose Soothing Balm with Natural Pawpaw, and this can be used for lips, for skin, for cuticles and beauty finishing and all of that stuff. It is fragrance free, so there's Nothing to lose. So I use this mainly as a lip balm overnight. I also have the Nivea lip balm, the cherry or the berry or the strawberry or the, I don't know what it is, but you know, the red Nivea lip balm, I do have that as well. So yeah, those are the lip balms I use. Another thing that I don't have right now with me is I use a lot of sheet masks. Currently I just put in my order for the Nykaa sheet masks. I'm not sure if they're really good or not, but I will give you an update maybe later or something. But that is my thing with face masks. When I was in the UK, I used to use the Superdrug you know, sheet masks or the normal masks that you get. When I was in the US, I was using what was it? I think it was the Body Shop or the face mask or both. Like I used to use, like, switch it up a lot. So those are the face masks that I use, or even like the CVS brand ones. Was it CVS? I'm not sure. One of like their own drugstore company face mask kind of thing. But right now I'm in India, so I'm gonna try out the Nykaa ones. I've heard they're really good, so I want to give it a shot. But yeah, face masks are something that you can use probably like once a week or twice a week. I like to do that whenever I can, so that's a lot, but maybe don't get into that. But yeah, these are all the products that I'm currently using. I know it's like not a lot of products, but these are the few products. I'm trying to use like less things on my face so it looks better. And yeah, I guess that is it. So if you guys really like this video, then please make sure to give it a big thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe if you are new to my channel. And I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!